called me, Meg Ryder. Today's topic is how to use social media to build your brand, build a reputation for what you do best, and attract opportunities, whether you're here for networking, to attract a business to consumer, business to customer, or a loyal community that will follow you, not just here on Instagram, but potentially on TikTok, Twitter, Facebook, etc. So to give a bit of a background of who I am a branding consultant. I've been working in marketing, communications, and business writing for the past 6 years. I've worked with different companies contractually and sometimes on a casual basis. And some of the companies include Intuit QuickBooks, the government of Alberta. And I can't name them all because I've had to sign non-disclosure agreements. But for the most part, I've worked with some of the biggest international companies and local companies here in my city. I'm very, very proud of what I do. I study social media for about 25 to 35 hours per week. And not just Instagram, I study TikTok, LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, I study YouTube. I get all of my tips and advice from the leaders on the planet, and I test everything that they say. And I can say that there have been times where I have taken some advice, used it for myself personally before I help anybody else. And unfortunately, some of those things don't work, but that is information that I definitely don't share here on social media with each and every one of you. So the first thing that you need to really think about when you're looking at your social media strategy and how you show up on the internet with your photos, your videos, etc., is your content high quality? Because if your content is not high quality, it's difficult for people to understand. People don't feel like they can achieve what you're actually advising them to do. It's going to be very, very difficult for you to turn some of your followers into customers, let alone some of your followers into loyal community members, so to say. So you always want to take a look at the quality of your message, how you sound, how you look, is your confidence on point, do you have enthusiasm? In addition to that, you have to think about the advice that you're giving. Is this advice working for your customers and clients? Is it working for your company? If you're giving bad advice, or maybe you're reading a textbook, hi Dreddy, thanks for joining. Topic today is how to get more customers on social media and how we can kind of all look at the videos and photos that we share to see what's working and what isn't. So I was saying just before you came in that the best thing that we can do is look at the quality of our captions, our writing, our videos. How are we showing up? Do we look enthusiastic? Do we look happy to share advice? Does our tone in our writing sound enthusiastic? Does it sound confident? Are we using words like will versus can? So instead of saying, can you do this? Or I can do this, are we saying confident words like I will be able to, for example, so that helps to build trust with their audience, whether they've been complete strangers or not. The other thing I was sharing as well is the quality of our content. Are we giving out advice that is working for us? Are we giving out advice that's working for our customers or our clients? And I say that because on LinkedIn, somebody put a post about content marketing and how when we're doing Facebook ads, we should ask people to sign up for our newsletter or something like that, try to get their email. So I wasn't really challenging the person that put this post, but I did ask her in a comment, you know, what is your conversion rate? If you're helping people and telling them to put an opt-in where people can opt in into their blog or the newsletter, what is their conversion rate? And she couldn't respond. And that's the kind of thing that I'm talking about, where when I say branding and marketing mistakes, I will never share advice to anybody on the internet that I haven't used for myself. And I was saying earlier, Dreddy, that I've been studying social media about 25 to 35 hours per week, not just on Instagram, TikTok, and everything. And I test a lot of the things that these quote-unquote marketers or even influencers are saying. The only information that I share here is information that's helping me out. Information that I see is helping people who are taking my advice, and information that's helping me with the clients and customers that I currently have. And so I say to everybody, anybody who's here on the line or anybody that's going to watch this video, is whatever you share, just make sure that it's going to give people a positive result. Don't read a textbook, don't watch a video, don't, you know, suppose this is going to be helpful, because if you're giving out average or non-high level information and people are using it and it doesn't work for them, what do you think is going to happen? Your credibility and your reputation is going to go down slowly, and that's what we don't want to do. I also want to say, when you're giving out information online so that you can build trust with your audience, is always have a disclosure. For example, you can say things like, this has worked for me and some of my customers, but it only works for customers that have these kind of problems, or customers that have these kind of issues. And always be specific when it comes to your disclaimers, because the last thing you want to do is for somebody who doesn't have these problems or issues to try it. It doesn't work, and again, your reputation or your brand is tainted because you weren't specific in saying, these are the types of things that work for people at this age group, in these locations, with this culture, etc. So always try to think about that. Be transparent and completely honest with your audience. I do my best to do that. Most of the videos that I share, I always kind of tell, this is what works for me and my audience. So that's kind of like a disclosure in itself, that my audience might be different than some of the viewers, but you can test it and see if it works for you. And if it doesn't, well, maybe you weren't a part of, you know, your demographic or your industry wasn't similar to my customers. But I always kind of put that kind of language out there. The other thing that we want to take a look at too, from when it comes from a content marketing perspective, is how are people engaging with their content? Are people bookmarking, liking, sharing? And if you have a business Instagram account, for example, or even a TikTok pro account, you can look at your insights and kind of see how people are reacting to your videos and the content that you're sharing. And that gives you a lot of information to know whether you should be continuing to do that, or maybe you need to tweak it a bit and change it up. Because we all have to keep in mind that every time we come on social media, every video, every caption, every photo, every infographic blog, whatever you're doing, it's a step away from building a connection with our audience. I can say for myself that I've had people follow me and within 24 hours they needed my service. I can also say that I've had people follow me and then 6 or 8 months later they came to me for my service. So every interaction and conversion from a follower to a customer is going to change. Just because somebody reaches out to you and asks you for your services and they don't get back to you, it doesn't mean anything about you. Maybe they're just not ready. Maybe they don't have the finances, or they have the finances, but they've got so many things on their plate that now is not the time. Many times before COVID, I've had companies come to me and say, what is your pricing? And they didn't get back to me. And I, you know, our mind goes to this negative mindset that, oh, maybe I'm not good enough, or maybe my prices were too high. But that's not the truth. 8 months later, they came back to me when they were ready. So every interaction that we have on social media is an interaction to show people who we are and how much we care about them. Some of the things that I just started doing so that I can kind of build a quick relationship with people that follow me is I send notes, sometimes text notes or voice notes to new followers, just saying, hey, you know, I really like your photo, or I see that you visited Hawaii. I went to Honolulu before. Looking forward to seeing more of your content. If you have any questions, let me know. That's it. Not sign up for my blog or subscribe to my YouTube channel. I always try to start off with that relationship building from the very beginning, because I don't know about you, but it's kind of hard to go back 2 months, 3 months later and say, hey, I know you've been following me for a couple of months. How are you doing? Sometimes people won't even respond to you because that there's no emotional or mental connection between you and that new follower. So try to reach out to new followers as much as you can, and even people that you admire. Try to recognize your followers too. If there's a painter or a retail designer that you admire, without any expectation of anything, getting anything back, or without any expectation of them, thanks Jetty, without any expectation of them resharing that story, put it up there. It's great, especially if this person has a big following and they get, you know, they get nice comments all the time. Show people that you appreciate them, and congratulate people. If they're saying, oh, today's my birthday, don't skip over a post like that. Genuinely say, wow, you look great for your age. If that's how you feel, happy birthday. I hope you have a great time on your special day. And try to build those relationships relationships and connections. It's really the small things that we do here on the internet that make people feel like we can trust them. I'll give you some more examples. On TikTok, I find that I'm a little bit more closer to my audience, not because I don't like Instagram, it's just the way the app is built. On TikTok, if somebody leaves a comment on my video, I can literally reply to their comment, and TikTok will automatically put their comment right above my video. And when I do stuff like that, it makes people feel good. So I'll give you an example. I have this teenager that follows me on TikTok, and she had left a comment on one of my videos saying that she just started her e-commerce business. Now, anybody in high school who's starting a business either knows what they're doing or they don't. And the most that I could do to make her feel like I see her is, instead of responding back with a text comment, I literally uploaded a 15-second video, congratulated her, and her response was full of joy, and she was just so happy because I just introduced her to my audience. So it's the little things like that that matter the most. Relationship building online is so good, and I really think that we as entrepreneurs, we have to think not so much what can I get for this person, but what can I give? Because as entrepreneurs, we're solving problems, retail problems, finance problems, business problems, marketing, health, etc. So we're here to solve problems, and we get paid good money when we get to that success in life, because we're doing it all on our own, or we're building an employee group of team to do what we do best, so we can stand back and do other things with our business. So when you're trying to think about customers, try to think about what kind of problem can I solve? What are their pain points? Meaning, what kind of issues do my followers have? Do they have issues with fashion? Do they have health issues? Do they have issues with filming videos for their business? Do they have issues with eating healthy? And when you know, okay, this is their pain point, this is their issue, then everything that we do online should be towards solving those problems, inspiring people, motivating them, and sometimes doing it in a fun, quirky or nerdy or a super hyped up, exciting kind of way, to show them that we see them. And thanks for joining AfroBiz. Today's topic is how to use social media to build our business. And I really think as long as we are customer or follower oriented, and we put all of our lead, sweat, and tears, so to say, into the customer or the potential customer or just the follower who's just following us because we make them feel happy, we can just stay in that mindset of serving them the way that when we go to a restaurant, the waiter and the waitress is serving us. And then what do you guys, in your experience, what's your favorite restaurant? And tell me why you like your favorite restaurants. I can say for myself, I have a couple of favorite restaurants in my city. Most of them are African. And although I like the Caribbean and the Asian and everything, the reason why I like going to the African restaurants in my city is because they make me feel like family. Every time I go in there, it's like, sister, how you doing? And it's like, I don't know if I can feel that way in a McDonald's or a Tim Hortons. I know that person will remember my face, but it's very, very unlikely that if I go into a Tim Hortons or a Starbucks, they're going to call me sista and make me feel like I'm their family and give me more rice or more food or more donuts. Or you see what I'm saying? So when you're on the internet, think about what extra thing can I say or do to make this person feel good? Because when you make them people feel good, it slowly builds down that, is this person trying to get my money? And that's something that we have to collectively do every day, is show up a little bit more for our audience. And it doesn't even mean showing up on like this marathon that I'm doing. I know you don't have the time, but it could just be adding a little bit more of an extra tip, adding a little bit more of an extra piece of advice that we generally probably wouldn't give somebody for free. And I'm not saying give all of your secrets away. It's just adding a little bit more so that one person that's at the stage of, maybe they're not at the beginning stage of just the stranger, but they're almost just about to buy something from you or contact you because they want to see if you are the right person that can help them solve their problems. It's just putting in that little effort. It can even just be changing up your content. What I did last night, for example, so that I can continue to share content that isn't repetitive or boring, or my followers are thinking, I've been following her for 2 years and I keep seeing the same thing. I literally took a piece of blank paper and I started looking at all of the videos. I started looking at the likes, the shares, the bookmarks, and the comments by clicking on the insights. Ladies, if you guys have a business page, I recommend that you convert. And I started taking a look at all of the topics that were shared, and I was noticing that the branding and marketing mistakes were the templates that were shared a lot, and I started pulling away from that. So what does that mean? I need to share a little bit more than that. I also noticed that the topics where it was like branding tips for men, for women only, branding tips for women, those got shared a little bit more than some of the stuff I'm sharing now. So now it's time for me to pivot back to what I was doing before, because if we don't give people what they want, even if we like the new stuff that we just created, what's gonna happen? Like, it's gonna be tone deaf. People are gonna comment less, like less, contact you less. So definitely take advantage of those insights. Take a look at what people are liking, doing. What are the comments? You know, take the energy of your audience, see how they're responding to your content. Are they just saying thank you? Are they just putting little emojis with hearts? Because that's not data to me and you, meaning that's not enough information to go by to know whether people like it or not. But if you're noticing on some of your content that people are literally writing 1 to 2 paragraphs, that sounds to me that that's a topic that you might want to kind of not recycle, but just, you know, add a little spice here in that next one. The last thing I want to say about using social media so that you can build a sales funnel of a small percentage, because I believe on Instagram, I believe less than 2% or about 2 to 3% of our followers will become customers. Now, I don't know if that's within a 1 year span or a lifetime span, but that's just the percentages that I was able to take on the internet. Is really everything that we do should just be about making people feel good. And we are not psychiatrists or psychologists, and that is not your job. I'm not asking any of you to, you know, I've seen somebody on LinkedIn, they're not a psychologist, but they put out a post about saying that they have experienced depression, and this person is in content marketing, and they were telling people, I've experienced depression, if you want to tell me about your depression, send a DM. We are not psychologists and clinical therapists. We should not be trying to help people. We can only help people with our talents and skills and what we do best, what we offer via a product or a service. So don't be afraid to also show your products and your stories. Just got this shipment, I'm super excited. Do a Reels video, have fun with your stuff. And just kind of show people what's coming up in the pipeline as well, so that you can kind of change some of those followers into customers or just loyal Instagram followers that will follow you on LinkedIn, Instagram, or other apps, basically. And that's it in a nutshell. If anybody has any questions, let me know. Tomorrow morning, I'm going live at the same time. I'm going to be interviewing an architectural company here in Edmonton. I'm super excited because it's a medium-sized company, and most of the people I was chatting with before were small businesses. So it'll be interesting to kind of hear about their thought process on architecture, the future of real estate. So if you want to join me tomorrow, I'll be online again, 9 a.m. Mountain Daylight Time, 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, and I believe that's 9 a.m., 10 a.m. Central Standard Time. So I'll keep it open for about 5 minutes. Does anyone have any questions at all about how to increase subscriptions, how to increase followers to customers, how to create a situation where a person can trust you from the very beginning? I was saying before, Afro Biz World, and I'm sure both of you have experienced this before, I'm greeting people now. I can't do it on TikTok because the messaging system on TikTok is really wonky, but on LinkedIn and on Instagram, I am greeting all of my new followers with voice messages, and I do my best to look at their profile first and kind of bring up something that's a little personalized, because I find that more of those people are going to look at my stories, they're going to look at my videos, they're going to interact with my content. And it's really hard, because I've done this before, and some people reply, it's hard to kind of not do this, and then 3 or 6 months later, you're now reaching out to them. And there's nothing wrong with that. Reach out to old followers just to say hi, especially if it looks like they abandoned their account. But if there's any way that from the beginning that you can build that relationship real quick, I've seen an uptick in my inquiries, an uptick in my leads, an uptick in people watching my stories. And that's really what we're here on social media to do, in the internet, is to build relationships the best way that we can. So Well, it looks like nobody has any questions. What I'm going to do is I'm going to upload this on IGTV. I'll keep it online for about, I'd say about 15, 30 minutes. And then I'm going to add it on my YouTube channel. And if you have any more questions, feel free to reach out. And if you've missed any of the lives that I've done over the past several weeks, you're more than free to check out my YouTube channel. I have more content coming soon. So I want to thank you ladies for joining me this morning. And I hope to see you online soon. And Dreddy and AfroBiz World, if you guys, you ladies are going to be going live and I see you and I have the time, I will be jumping in more people's lives, because that's also another way. If you think about it, I know it's hard when we're on our computer and stuff like that, and it's difficult. Oh, thank you for today's snippets. Oh, no problem. But I will be jumping on your live. It's not that, if you don't see me on your live, it's not that I'm not supporting you. Sometimes I literally have to jump on a project and stuff like that, or go out and meet people in person. But I'm going to start doing that a little bit more, because that's another way to build relationships, ladies, is jump on people's lives, even if it's just for 5 minutes. You're not committed to stay the full 30 minutes or an hour. And just say, hey, and you don't know how much that makes people feel is when they see followers that they wouldn't expect. Jump on their live, sit for 5 or 10 minutes, just say hi, and you know, and dip out. You don't have to stay the whole time, but that's also building relationships. Even if it's a topic that you don't care about, you never know if that person is sitting there feeling like nobody's listening. They only have one or two people on the live. That really makes people feel good. That's another way to build relationships. So I'll upload this. Thanks so much, ladies. Hope to see your lives if you do go live this week and I see you and I have some time. And hope to see you soon online. Bye, everybody.